What is up, guys? Welcome to another Tonix Tuesday. And today, we're going to be taking a look at their PT Experience 2015 Episode 8, where we are going to be exploring Paris and, I would imagine, performing somewhere in Paris and celebrating King's Day. So I would imagine if they're celebrating it, it has got to be some sort of holiday. I have never heard of King's Day before, so this should be interesting. I just, you know, love experiencing, well, maybe not experiencing, but I love learning new things, especially new things that like cultures celebrate. So this should be a really good time. So thank you guys all so, so much for watching. Let's go ahead and get into it.
Yeah, let's walk.
Dear Paris, thanks for having me. Just a small town boy, walking the streets.
This is the picture you post on Instagram.
Just a small town boy.
I would love to go inside. I want to take a picture like Beyonce and Jay-Z with Scott.
I know, but we'd have to get everyone out of the way.
You see.
We'll see.
Go to the Love Lockbridge. There's a
Lockbridge.
So pretty.
Oh, really, yeah. Cool. Didn't they have
Everyone
to cut all those
Paris,
off?
I always have an amazing time.
Me too.
Really stunning. Best friends in Paris. Best friends in Paris. C'est la vie.
So cute. So apparently in this one, they are kind of doing things Scott more just two of them or just one of them. Kind of doing their own thing for a little bit. That's cool.
Paris, day two. We're heading to the Eiffel Tower.
That was scary. I feel like I'm on a ride at Universal.
Oh my god.
That is cool.
Oh shit, that is pretty cool. I've always wanted to go to France. Aww. Just like wild bunnies.
So cute.
Oh, you scared me. That scared me. You see him charge at me like that?
I like how we're in Paris at the Eiffel Tower and all we can focus on are these bunnies. But that's okay.
They are just so cute.
In front of the Eiffel Tower. This is a weird moment, but I love it.
It feels amazing being here. We've been here a couple times now, and it's seriously so beautiful.
As beautiful as the Eiffel Tower is, I have to get back to soundcheck because I am very late.
Damn it. What are you doing, Scott?
Paris is unreal. It's just like on another level. Like the fans are just, I don't know, I can't really explain the energy. It's crazy.
Paris, on vous aime. We love you, Paris.
It looked like a different kind of cello. Oh yeah, I think I saw he had an electric cello for this tour. Maybe those are easier to replace than Beyonce in case he forgets it at the hotel.
I had my voice back, and I was living, and they were living, and it was so much fun.
I thought the show was amazing. It was so fun. I was like gross energetic.
Bonsoir, Paris. That was one of the craziest shows of all time. They really nailed it. They really nailed it.
They really nailed it.
It was a lot of fun.
I was literally like, this is what I love to do.
We were all like in the same place. You know what I mean? Like everybody in the room.
So do they still do the like audience participation now that Scott has his voice back?
To take us into the city, King's Day.
The King's Day!
We're all wearing orange!
What is that face? Wow, there is a lot of orange.
My name is Kirsten, you can call me Kirsty.
So is it like a sporting thing? Like for some kind of like football team or something?
Oh,
what is that?
We go! Let's go!
that does look like fun. Oh.
We're not even at the top yet.
Oh my god. It's starting to look like less fun. Jesus. Oh, my hands are sweating. Yeah, that might be too high. That might be a little too high.
What I learned is the harder you hit it, the better things happen.
Okay. Good job, girl. Yes.
Go for Kate. Hey, how are we looking?
Oh,
give me a minute.
You're doing something really important right now.
You're doing something very important right now?
Go. Maybe next time, Indiana.
Maybe next time, Indiana.
Beyonce played here 12 years ago, so that means we will have shared the same stage.
You ready to rock and roll?
So I still have no idea what King's Day is. God, just that sea of people in the general admission area. I need to go to a concert. Not Pentatonix, but just anything. I think New Kids in the Block are playing tomorrow.
Can I know something?
Yeah, I won.
Kevin ain't swole enough to catch me.
Ooh.
He weak. He weak than a mother.
Oh, shit! See? Wait, no. Do it again. One, two, three. Yeah, what's
swole
up?
Check. Swole check. Swole check.
God, Kevin's gonna throw his back out trying to do Scott curls. That would be the worst. Somebody out there, please explain to me what King's Day is. I just gave it like a little Google search, and from what I saw, it's the celebration of the day that the three wise men came to baby Jesus or something like that. So I don't get all of the orange everywhere and like the big rides and the waffles and stuff. So I don't think that that's like the day that I'm looking for. But then again, you know, what does the Easter Bunny have to do with Easter? What does a big fat dude in a red suit have to do with Christmas? Not a whole lot. So yeah, if somebody wouldn't mind explaining that to me, I would very much appreciate it. But man, everything in Paris just looks so beautiful. I really, really, really do need to just to go, like, one day. And apparently it's, like, infested with wild bunnies. I did not know that. I know at the very least the island of Maui in Hawaii is, like, overrun with feral chickens, which is something I was not expecting to see, but bunnies in Paris, that is pretty much worth the plane ticket just right there. And it was fun to see them like ride these rides, but that swing, when it first started, it's like, yeah, it's not really going too terribly high. I could probably go on it, even though I'm not a huge fan of rides, but my God, it just kept rising and rising. I couldn't do it. That was just too high for me. I could honestly barely watch. I got the sweaty palms, knees weak, mom's spaghetti, all that stuff. It would not have been good for me to try, but it was very pretty to look at and to see the footage from it. But these videos really just make me very, very aware of the fact that I have not traveled or really even went to a show in like months. And that is very sad. Like, I'm probably gonna have to go and book something. Maybe a concert ticket, maybe a flight to somewhere random just to explore, but I need to get out. Pentatonix, you have inspired me to get out and travel somewhere. I will keep you guys posted where I end up going. But thank you all so, so much for watching. Have an awesome rest of your Tonix Tuesday, and I will see you next week for episode 9.